Okay, in this video we show that K4 is not planar, okay, using a very simple argument. So this kind of arguments can be used to show that, okay, some simple graphs are non-planar, okay, if that graph is non-planar, okay. So here we will discuss one simple argument, and again in a later video we will prove that K5 is non-planar in a very different way, okay. So in this video we are going to discuss one simple argument to show that K5 is non-planar, okay. Okay, so K5 is nothing but a complete graph on 5 vertices. So this K5, it has 5 vertices and 10 edges. Okay, since it is a complete graph on 5 vertices. Okay, and so let the vertices be say v1, v2, v3, v4 and v5. Okay, so we know that K5 is a Hamilton cycle. So it has a Hamilton, okay, it has a Hamilton graph, so it has a Hamilton cycle. Okay, and so let that cycle be say like v1, v2, v3, v4, v5 and back to v1. Okay, so it has 5 vertices, so it must include this cycle must it's a since it is a Hamilton cycle, it must include all the 5 vertices, okay, that's here. And out of this 10 edges, okay, this must contain 5 edges. Okay, so out of those 10 edges, okay, this C must contain 5 edges. Okay, so let's draw that particular Hamilton cycle. Okay, so we have this cycle C, and let them be label the vertices as v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. Okay, so we can see that it uses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges. Okay, so we used 5 out of this 10, so 5 edges are remaining. Okay. And here again we can see that, okay, here this particular cycle, suppose that this cycle divides the plane into two regions, say R1 and R2. Okay, and the remaining 5 edges should be drawn either in this R1 or R2. Okay, so the remaining 5 edges should be drawn either in, okay, that interior region R1 or R2. Okay, so let's see what is going to happen. Okay, so we have these two regions and we are left with 5 edges. Okay, and we should draw that 5 edges in this R1 or R2. Okay, and suppose that the edges say V5 and V3. Okay, so suppose that the edges V5 and V5 V3 and say V1 V3. Okay, these two edges are drawn in R1. Okay, so get the edges V5, V3 and V1, V3 be drawn in. Okay, it can be down in R1, okay, without closing the edges, okay, without edge crossings. Okay, so far so good. Okay, so after that we have used 1 7 plus, okay, 5 plus 2 7 edges, and we are left with 3 more edges. Okay, so let's add 2 more edges between this V4 and V1. Okay, so we can add this edge without closing, and we can add one more, say V4 and V2. Okay, so we added these two edges in, say, R2 or something like that. Okay, so the edges in this case, this V4, V1, and V4, V2. Okay, it can be drawn in R2 without edge crossing. Okay, so we have used 9 edges, and we need to add one more edges. Okay, and that is going to be between between this V5 and V2. Okay, so let's see what is going to happen if you are going to add that edge. Okay, so in this case we can see that if you add the edge in this way, okay, we have this crossing, so we are stuck. Okay, and similarly we can also see that that's one way to add this thing. Another way could be something like this way. Okay, in this case also we can see that we got stuck, because here we have this crossing. Okay, and that's the only two ways that we can add this edge V5, V2. In either case we got stuck. Okay, and that says this K5 is, it is not planar. Okay, so that's the argument. Okay, so let me write down what I said. Okay, now we are left with one edge. Okay, now the edge V2, V5. Okay, so this edge is remaining. Okay, it is remaining, and we can see that it cannot be added to that graph without crossing. Okay, which cannot be drawn without edge crossing. Okay, and that's what we saw here. Okay, either we have to go from V5 to V2 through this region R1. So if that's the case, then we got stuck, we have this crossing. Or the other way, okay, V5 to V2 using this thing. Okay, if you go that way, again we got stuck. Okay, so this is by the basic Bridgen-Hall kind of thing. So if you consider the cycle, we have two regions R1 and R2, and we have two edges, right? So it must, two edges must lie either in R1 or in R2. Okay, and if it belongs to R1, then again it will cross something like this, and if it passes through this R2, okay, we can see that, okay, these two edges crosses. Okay, so now the edge V2 V5 remains, which cannot be drawn without edge crossing. Okay, and that says K5 is non-planar. Okay, so in a later video we will give another argument that shows that K5 is not planar. Okay, so we showed K5 is non-planar by using this kind of argument. So we can use this kind of argument for simple graphs. So in general it would be very difficult to use this kind of argument. Okay, so we will see one characterization called Kruczewski's theorem, and okay, that will help us to show that certain graphs are not planar. Okay, so that we will discuss in a future video.